Hi everyone, my name is Pauline. As a nuclear medicine resident, I often see patients with prostate cancer. This is why I made a series of videos in which I explain everything related to the prostate. From benign prostatic hyperplasia to prostate cancer to some important diagnostic tools. You can choose to watch them all, or you can go to the playlist and watch the videos that seem interesting to you. In this video, I will tell you how you as a doctor can recognize and diagnose prostate cancer. The different treatment options will be discussed in detail in the next video. Prostate cancer usually causes no symptoms until it reaches an advanced stage. Sometimes symptoms similar to those of benign prostatic hyperplasia develop, including difficulty urinating and a need to urinate frequently or urgently. But these symptoms do not develop until after the cancer grows large enough to compress the urethra and partially block the flow of urine. Later, prostate cancer may cause bloody urine or a sudden inability to urinate. In some men, symptoms of prostate cancer develop only after it metastasizes. The areas most often affected by cancer spread are the bones, typically the pelvis, the vertebral column, or the ribs. Prostate cancer is usually suspected based on the symptoms, the results of a digital rectal examination, or the results of the PSA blood tests. Sometimes stony hard indurations or nodules are palpable during a rectal examination, but the examination is most often normal. The diagnosis of prostate cancer is made with histological evidence from a biopsy of the prostate. When doing a biopsy, doctors usually first obtain images of the prostate by inserting an ultrasound probe into the rectum. The biopsy sample is then obtained through the rectal probe. Usually 10 to 12 samples are taken from the prostate. Taking many samples increases the likelihood of finding a small cancer. By examining tissue samples under a microscope, the diagnosis of cancer can be established. When a tumor is discovered, its grade and stage must be determined. Grading is a way of classifying cancer cells based on their appearance. It helps define the aggressiveness of the tumor. Traditionally, prostate cancer grades were described according to the Gleason score. Dr. Gleason realized that cancerous cells fall into five distinct patterns as they changed from normal cells to tumor cells. Grade 1 cells resemble normal prostate tissue, and cells closest to 5 are considered high grade and have mutated so much that they barely resemble normal cells. The pathologist looking at the biopsy sample will assign one Gleason grade to the most predominant pattern in the biopsy and a second Gleason grade to the second most predominant pattern. For example, 3 and 4. The two grades will then be added together to determine the Gleason score. Theoretically, Gleason scores range from 2 to 10, but the Gleason grades 1 and 2 have been eliminated, so as a result, Gleason scores will range from 6 to 10, with 6 being the lowest grade cancer, 7 is intermediate grade, and a score of 8 to 10 is a high grade cancer. But because many prostate cancer cases are extremely slow-growing, the Gleason system didn't necessarily do a good job of communicating the risks for these cases. Patients with scores of 6 and 7 didn't have a clear picture of the nature of their particular cancer. To address these issues, a new 5-grade group system has been developed in 2014, with 1 being low-grade cancer and 5 being high-grade cancer. A cancer stage, on the other hand, explains how large the primary tumor is and how far the cancer has spread in the patient's body. Doctors assign the stage of the cancer by combining the TNM classification, the PSA level, and the Gleason score. Imaging techniques such as CT, MR, and PET-CT may aid in the staging by evaluating the location and extent of the tumor. MRI is often used for surgical planning, specifically to define the relationship of the tumor to the neurovascular bundle and to determine the need of sacrificing the nerves. The next step is to design a treatment plan. The different treatment options will be discussed in detail in the next video.